George Collins went up on May morn, and May was in full bloom. And there he espied a fair pretty maid. She was washing a white marble stone, a stone. She was washing a white marble stone. She hooped and she hollered so loud, waving her lily white hand. "Come hither to me, George Collins," cried she, "for your life it might not last you long, you long. Your life it might not last you long." He put his bent bow down on the bankside, and it's over the river he sprang, and he's placed his hands on a middle sow small, and he's kissed a red rosy lips, her lips, he's kissed a red rosy lips. George Collins went to his own house, and he knocked at the ring. "Arise, arise, dear father," he cried, "arise and let me in, me in. Arise and let me in. Arise, arise, dear mother," he cried, "arise and make my bed. Arise, arise, dear sister," he cried, "with a napkin to tie round my head, with a napkin to tie round my head. For if I die tonight, as I am afraid I might, then bury me under that white marble stone that lies in fair Ellender's hall, her hall, that lies in fair Ellender's hall. Fair Ellender sat in a hall one day. She was weaving with silk and twine, when the finest corpse came right up to her, that ever the sun did shine on, shine on, that ever the sun did shine on. Fair Ellender said unto her head maid, 'Whose corpse is this so fine?' She made a reply, 'George Collins's corpse. He was once a true lover of thine, of thine. He was once a true lover of thine.' Then put him down here, you brave little boys, and open the coffin so wide, so that I may kiss George Collins' lips. For the 10,000 times he's kissed mine, kissed mine, all the 10,000 times he's kissed mine. Now go you upstairs and fetch the white sheet that's woven